And this is the design stage number two. And in this stage, the designer define the detection and alarm zones, okay? And in detection zones, we mean the sensors location, okay? And to define the boundaries of the zone or the fire alarm loop according to the type of fire alarm detection addressable or conventional, okay? And it is not recommended or it's recommended to make all the floor one loop, okay? To make all the floor one loop, or to make the loop assigned to only one floor, whatever a loop or a zone, okay? So each floor should has its own loop or its own zone, okay? Unless the area of the floor is less than 300 square meters. So if floor less than 300 square meters, okay, you can assign the zone to more than one floor, okay? But for floors, if floor, okay, its area is bigger than 300 meters, okay, and less than 2000 meters, okay, square meters, okay, you should assign a separate loop or a separate zone for each floor, okay? And for open areas which have no ceiling, okay, like open garage, okay, one loop can cover up to loop or zone can cover up to 10,000 square meters, okay? So it's recommended to assign a complete zone for each floor unless the floor area is less than 300 square meters, okay? And if the floor area is bigger than 300 and less than 2000 square meters, you can assign all, or you should assign all the floor to one loop, okay? And also you can assign it to more than one loop, okay? Why? Because this area maybe includes a lot of spaces, okay, a lot of rooms, okay, and these rooms requires a lot of smoke detectors or heat detectors, and the number of detectors is more than the number which could be supported by one loop, okay? So in this case, you will add a number of loops to cover the floor, okay? But what is not recommended to divide the loop or the zone between two floors unless you have to, okay? So this is about zones, loops, and floors, okay? We have loop 1 or zone 1, loop 2 or zone 2, loop 3 or zone 3, loop 4 or zone 4, okay? Consideration. Okay, you have to consider that the stairs, all the stairs on the all floors, so the stairs on all floors should be on a separate loop or zone. Okay, so the zone of stairs connected to each other for all floors, okay, and it is not connected to the floor zone. It is not connected to the floor zone, okay? But all manual call point on the stairs should connected to the floor loop. All manual call points on the stairs should connected to the floor loop. So here it's recommended to make or to assign a loop or a zone to a separate floor, a zone for each floor. All stairs should be on one loop, all vertical stairs, okay? If we have another stair here, okay, we will assign another zone or loop to this stair also. And all manual call points on this stair also shall be connected to the floor zone, okay? So this is about detection zones, okay? And for alarm zones, it's recommended to add and to divide your building to a zones, okay? And all floor should be a one zone. All floor should be a one zone. And maybe the floor have or has many detection zones, okay? But it will have only one alarm zone, okay? So the floor should be one alarm zone. Also, the floor could be have more than detection zone or detection area at the same time, okay? So for alarm zones, each floor should be all. The floor should be as a one alarm zone, okay? And although the floor could have more than one detection zone, okay? So this is about alarm and detection zones in fire alarm design.